of you would ask a girl to marry you the first time you see her? Welcome back to another episode of David Sin Outlast. Now maybe you will say, hey, I'm the guy. Well, you know what? There's no hiding. Don't shy away. You know, just go and ask, right? You know what? Very good energy. Now, having good energy is a little bit different from the actual reality of the whole process. Now, I'm going to first make an assumption that actually 95% of the girl would just say no, mainly because of one thing. They don't know you. Yes, because to them, you're just an invisible person. They don't even know anything about you. And this is a very typical process to meet a girl. First, you know about them, and she knows a little bit more about you. And if she thinks you're good material, then you move on to the next stage, which is dating, whether it's for a couple of months to a couple of years. Eventually, if the both of you are ready mentally, then you will eventually get married. But getting married on the first day when you ask her to is literally really, really rare. And if this is true for a dating relationship, why would people believe that this can happen in business, in sales? Now, before we go further, let's just look at the whole process of how you sell your service to your client. In the case of selling a product, it's very similar. You still need to let your potential client to know about you first. And then, once your client knows about you, then they have to build a certain level of trust. Now, once they trust you, eventually, if you're lucky, you will get to the stage that they will buy from you. And this whole process has one phenomenon. Assuming 10 people know about you at the beginning, 10 potential clients. Now, once you get to the stage that some of them trust you, maybe the conversion rate is just about 50%, meaning that maybe at most 5 people will start to trust you. And once you have 5 people who trust you, from trusting you to buying from you, maybe the conversion rate is another 50%. And maybe you have about 2 or 3 people that will eventually buy from you. Now, that whole process from 10 people who knows about you till at the end 2 or 3 people who buys from you, this is a very typical phenomenon that we see in any sales activity. To getting a girl to know you, getting a customer to buy from you is a very similar process. From knowing you all the way to trusting you to buying from you. Now, there are 2 properties about this relationship that we want to focus on today. Now, the first thing is, in order to get someone to buy from you, and since the conversion rate pretty much from 10 people knowing you till 2 or 3 people will buy from you at the end, your job as a salesperson for your business is to make sure that you get to know, you get as many people to know about you as possible. If you want this number to increase, say, increase to, 30 people to buy from you, what that means is the number of people who know about you also has to be increased by 10 times as well. And this is exactly the same. This is exactly the most important principle. Get as many people to know you, know about your business, and not to let yourself be that invisible man that they don't know about. And the second most important thing is moving from that no stage to trusting you. This, you have to put as much effort as possible. And in the case of social media marketing, what happened is people will give lots of free and useful information about your industry, your focus. Because remember, you are supposed to be the specialist in your industry. Don't be the same as every single guy in this market. Or don't go low. Don't just use low price to compete. You shall become the specialist in your industry, in your business sector. And by having that specialist mentality, you will give the free and most useful information about your industry to your target customers. Now, this may take a while, can be from a few months all the way to even to a few years. And any big companies like Google, Amazon, they all build from scratch. It takes years to build a great brand. And once they trust you, then eventually, if you're lucky, then they will do a buy from you. And this is exactly what we have to learn. Today we talk about three things. First, the process of sales that convert, that because every step involved would have like a headcount drop. That is why if you want your sales to be great and efficient, number one thing you shall do is to make sure as many people know about your presence as possible. And the second thing is moving from the know, from people knowing you till they trust you, give them as much free information through social media, Facebook, WhatsApp. Give them the free information that they will find helpful. And as they recognize you are the specialist in this, in the industry you are in, they will all come to you. And that's how money flows in.